Through this tutorial series, we focused on the capturing of current state to be able to identify wastage in our information supply chains so that we can find an opportunity to mitigate that wastage and make our organizations more efficient and effective. There are other use cases for LINQ. This current state capture, of course, translates directly to a visual business case. We're able to model the current state, identify where our wastage is by using things like the balance scorecard in order to navigate through our data and find the most expensive action in the most expensive area of our organization, identify the key thing that needed to be resolved, and then model what that would look like if we were to mitigate, in this case, manually importing bank statements in order to be able to reconcile them. This way of being able to visualize a business case, current state and target state, with all of the evidence supported through our capture, makes the conversation with the decision maker much easier. They can challenge us, and we are able to respond to that challenge by showing the data that we've captured, but modify it where necessary. We can get really specific around single processes with LINQ as well. Here's an example of how a management report is generated. We can see the project officer extracting data from a data warehouse into Excel spreadsheets, analyzing those spreadsheets in order to determine the key data that's required for the project director to combine them into a management report, which is then distributed. The dashboards help us understand the cost of this process. In this case, just under $430,000 a year, and through the people dashboard, identify the people involved in the process so that we can see where those costs are and understand how we might be able to change people's work in order to ensure that they are adding value to our organization. We can use LINQ to model one individual's job, in this case, Earl. Earl was originally hired into this organization to do bookkeeping. When he decided it was time to move on, there was an opportunity to model everything that he did in order to help HR understand what a suitable replacement might look like. By completing the capture of the information supply chain, we're able to use the people dashboard in order to get a visual representation of everything that Earl does. The cost value bubble chart shows the distribution of Earl's work in terms of cost and value to the organization. The number of outcomes that Earl supports leads us to believe that he does more than just bookkeeping. The dashboard's able to provide us with a visual view of everything that he does and how his actions LINQ to the information assets that he touches, which in turn enable the business outcomes. This dashboard provides a really significant view of the jobs that he did, showing he was a jack of all trades, and if we're going to replace him, we might not just be looking for a bookkeeper. And finally, we could step up a level. We can use LINQ to model data flows between organizations. In this example, we're looking at government and how agencies share information to one another in order to create reports that meet government objectives. All of these scenarios are enabled by LINQ's language, focusing on information, action, system and people. By accurately recording information supply chains and modeling the flow through them, we're able to dramatically increase the level of knowledge that we have about the information assets that we have in our organization and the value that they deliver to our business.